In this professional portrait photo editing in Photoshop tutorial video, I will show you how you can quickly turn this photo to something like this. I will discuss a lot of quick tips and tricks that I use in Photoshop that will help you in editing your photos in Photoshop. So I will suggest you to watch this video till the end. So as you can see, I have opened up the raw photo in Camera Raw filter in Photoshop. If you don't know how to open up a JPG photo in Camera Raw, then you can just open up your image in Photoshop and apply Camera Raw filter from the filter tab to your image layer and it will open up in Camera Raw editor. I took this photo of Rhea with my elder brother's Canon 5D Mark III along with a Canon 50mm f1.8 lens in my studio. You can follow her in Instagram. She has also worked with me in my upcoming short film Paranoia to be released in the official YouTube channel of my company Flix Canvas. So I will suggest you to subscribe to that channel now if you don't want to miss any updates about the film. You can also check out the details of all the gears that I use and recommend and use my Amazon affiliate links to buy the products. You can find all the links in the video description below. So you can see the white balance of the image is slightly cooler, especially in the highlights. Let's correct that with the white balance tool. Let's pick this white dot to sample. This is like telling Photoshop that this pixel should be white and Photoshop will try to fix the white balance accordingly. I will further adjust it to my taste with the sliders. Sometimes it's a good idea to increase the sliders a lot and then dialing back to find the sweet spot. You can apply this trick to any of the sliders. You can always double click on any of the sliders to reset to default. So don't shy away from experimenting. Now I will try to increase the brightness of the image and flatten the contrast quite a bit. We will add contrast later. This is kind of a trick to virtually increase the dynamic range of the image. Let's counter the highlights with this white slider. This is the extreme highlight range of the image. We can also play with the clarity slider and see if it is doing any good. In most cases, especially for beauty portraits like this, I usually don't use this slider. But in this case, I think keeping this to somewhere around 30 is helping the image to pop a bit. You can also decrease the clarity to negative 5 or 10 to smoothen up the skin. But she has pretty good skin and we can deal with the skin later with some advanced techniques. Okay, the exposure correction is done. You can see the before and after. A lot of detail is revealed and along with it, a lot of noise is also introduced. So let's do the noise reduction. I don't use the sharpening process here and like to sharpen my images as a last process in my edit chain. You can also zoom in the image to see the noise reduction properly. You can crank up the luminance value quite a bit in images like this because it can make your image a bit soft. Which in this case is not that bad a thing, rather it will smoothen the skin a lot. But for images where a lot of detailing is present, I won't recommend to go past 50. You can counter the luminance with the luminance detail slider, which will bring back some of the minute details from the image. You should use these two sliders in conjunction to find a proper balance of noise reduction without loss of sharpness. But in this image, I don't mind losing minute details which are most likely to be skin imperfections. Bringing up the luminance contrast slider will make the transitions natural. I don't like color noise, so I like to reduce the color noise a lot. Now, this is the portion where the magic will happen. The HSL tab or the Hue, Saturation and Luminance tab, where you can target specific colors in your image to change the vibrance and brightness or the color altogether. In studio portraits like this, where the background is monochrome and you do not have much to do with that, you need to create contrast within your subject. In this case, we will try to create some color contrast with complementary colors pink and teal. I will try to change the color of a lipstick to more of a neon pink and will complement that by changing the color of a top more towards cyan. So I target her top with the blue slider and force it towards cyan. Let's increase the saturation a bit. you can subtract the warmth from a skin tone with the orange slider. In most cases, the skin tone resides in the orange and yellow range depending on the light. I will increase the luminance or brightness of her skin to create focus on her face. Let's decrease the other colors to create contrast. Let's check the before and after. Already you can see a huge difference. Now you can use split toning for a more magazine look. You can see the difference. You can also apply a bit of dehaze to add contrast. Let's go back to the exposure tab and fine-tune some of the settings before opening up the image in Photoshop for further adjustments. Now you can see what we have done to the image so far only inside Photoshop Camera Raw. You can apply the same techniques and do a lot more in Lightroom also. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and let me know in the comment section below if you want Lightroom tutorials as well and what would you like me to cover in my next professional photo editing tutorial. Now, let's open up the image in Photoshop and quickly do the retouching. I will clean the stray hairs and also the blemishes with the healing brush tool. I'm sure you know how to properly use this tool, and if you don't, then just let me know in the comment section below and I will make a tutorial specially for you. Let's speed up this whole process and just follow along. And for your information, I would also like to let you know that I'm accepting photo editing orders in Fiverr. If you want me to edit your photos, then you can quickly contact me and check out more details about my gig on Fiverr. You will find the link to my Fiverr gig in the video description below. Okay, the healing process is done. Let's do the frequency separation for the skin retouching. For the sake of this tutorial, I will show you a quick and dirty way of frequency separation that gives fast and effective results when you are in a hurry. I will not recommend using this technique if you are doing this professionally for a client, as this can sometimes give you unnatural results and would suggest you to take your time in the frequency separation process. And in case you have no idea about frequency separation, then you know what to do. Comment below for a tutorial. What I'm doing here is, I have duplicated the low layer and will blur it till the skin color looks smooth. I have set the keyboard shortcut for the last applied filter to Command plus F for my Mac and using that to quickly apply the filter. For Windows, you can set it to Control plus F or anything you prefer. I have intentionally overdone it and will dial it back later on. Now hold the Option button for Mac or the Alt button for Windows and click this Add Mask icon to add an inverted mask. Now with the lasso tool and a feather of 20 pixels, I'm quickly drawing on the skin to isolate it and filling it up with white to reveal the smoothened skin. I'm using multiple layers of that to control the amount of smoothening with the opacity slider in different parts of the skin. You can check the before and after. The skin is looking much smoother and also not looking absolutely plasticky. Here you can be done with the skin smoothening, but let me add a skin glow. Flatten the image with Shift plus Command plus Option plus E for Mac and Shift plus Control plus Alt plus E for Windows. This will create a new layer with all the previous adjustments. Let's apply Gaussian blur to the layer. A lot of blur. Then change the blending mode to either overlay or soft light. To minimize the effect, add a curves adjustment layer and add a clipping mask to it, which will make the adjustment layer affect only the underlying layer. This will also increase the contrast a bit, along with making the skin smoother. Now I will do the dodging and burning process. For the sake of the length of this tutorial, I will speed up this section. You can just follow along. Or if you are not yet comfortable with dodging and burning, you can totally skip this step for now until I come up with another tutorial. Before finishing the edit with some minor levels, colors and vibrance adjustments, and as a last step, sharpening with the high pass filter, I would like to thank today's sponsor, Videoblocks. If you need awesome stock video footage to spice up the overall production quality of your projects, then you can check out the video description to find the link to the Videoblocks website and try out the 7-day free trial or avail discounts on their already affordable membership plans. They have millions of professional stock footage, After Effects templates, and motion backgrounds. So, this is it. I hope that this video has been helpful to some. Don't forget to share and subscribe right now.